In this video, we're going to be talking about how you can run the air raid offense in Madden 22. Now, if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe. I upload new videos every single day that can help you become a better Madden player. Also want to let you know that in this video, we're going to be talking about the air raid out of the Arizona Cardinals offensive playbook. I'm going to be talking about some of the spread sets in it. If you want to get my full air raid offensive ebook, it is in my Patreon. So in the description below, there's a link to my Patreon. You can sign up for that. It's just 10 bucks a month. It gets you access to every ebook that I've done and every ebook that I'm going to do while your subscription is active. We've got over 13 offensive and defensive guides available to you. Literally, as soon as you sign up, you get all the access to all the content. So if you want to sign up for that, that is going to be linked in the description below. What we're talking about today, one of my favorite concepts in the air raid, and that is the shallow cross concept. I love this play because I think that it's one of the more simple and at the same time one of the more effective concepts in the air raid offense. We're going to show you a couple of tricks with it that I like to use in Madden. It just makes it even better. And we're going to talk about how I like to run this. It's literally against any defense you can do this. This is such a good concept. So super excited to break this down. So let's just go ahead and go right into it. Like I said, Arizona Cardinals playbook is what we are talking about today. And you can honestly do this out of any play in the formation. Any play in the formation, you can do this concept. But what I'm going to show you today is just the Y shallow cross in the spread Y slot formation. We may do some adjustments and things like that, but I just want to go over that primary concept. So Y shallow cross. Now, if we take a look here real quick at this, what I like to do is I actually like to run this. I want my drag to have the most amount of field to be able to run. And basically the way this concept is going to work is he's our number one target on this play. It's simply a play that is designed to get a player in space. And what we're going to do on the outside here is we can basically just run straight streaks. I mean, we don't have to do anything really fancy. We could put a post. We could also put two streaks. If we wanted to, we could actually run this concept out of the four verticals, right? We could simply just drag that guy, and it's basically the same thing, okay? My point is that the shallow cross was originally designed to be something that was complementary to four verticals. In a lot of ways, it was simply a tag off of four verticals, and really it was designed to, again, get this guy in space, okay? So the defender we're going to be keying on is the guy that is over the top of the triangle receiver. So the nickel back over there on the left, or if that was a linebacker, you know, same kind of difference. But basically what we're looking at here is we're trying to open up space to be able to throw the ball underneath that triangle receiver to the shallow. So if that corner on the left side, if he goes high, we're going to throw the drag. If he goes low, then we're going to actually look to throw the dig over the middle of the field, which is, it's actually about a, it's a little bit over 10 yards, okay? So what you'll see here, oh, they back up. Okay, we're going to take the drag, and we just want to ideally get 7 to 10 yards. If we get more than 7 to 10 yards, that's great, okay? So we're just looking to get something simple here, just get some simple yardage here for the offense. Okay, so that's cover four. So now if they shade, let's say they try to get underneath things. Well, if they try to get underneath things, as you can see, the middle of the field is now going to be wide open. Now, this is where I like to teach people a principle in Madden that's a little bit different than the way that they would run this in the true air raid personnel, and primarily because of the user in Madden. So in Madden, most people are going to use her in the middle of the field. So they're going to go to the drag, and they're going to jump back on the post, and that's, or the in route. And the reason that I teach it this way in Madden is because we want to try to really get their user to have to be wrong. And we want to try to punish him if he's wrong. And in my opinion, the best way to do that is you could do it in one of two ways. You could either use a crossing route or you could use a post route. Now, my favorite is the post route to use. So what we're going to do is we're going to put Godwin on a post. And now what you're going to notice is if they guess wrong, so like if they go down, you're going to see I'm going to have a lot more space over the middle to now hit this route in multiple different directions, right? In multiple different directions. the way the slot apprentice post actually really practically plays out, it's just mainly a deeper dig route. And so that's why I like to use it in this situation. So let's say you're getting kind of the patented double Mabel concept here. And then again, they're going to use her right in here. Well, where we're going to put them in a situation is they're going to have to use her the post, right? So here they use her the post. Well, now you see there's nothing we can really make them pay with if they're in a double flat type of scenario, okay? So another little way that I like to make people pay out of this is actually by tagging some other stuff within this too. So you can kind of do this, you know, again, depending on how you want to do this, you can certainly do it differently than I'm doing it here. But what I like to do is take this circle receiver, and instead of running him off vertically, because I really don't feel like it accomplishes a ton in this, because we have this backside post here, what I'm actually going to do is put him on a zig route. Now, again, if you want to run him off vertically, that's fine, and it still works within the context of the shallow crossing concept. However, if you want to have a check down, you could put him on a zig, and then if you want, you could put the back on a wheel, you could block the running back. The only reason I'm saying that is now, let's say for example, you see how this outside third on the cover three is going to sit on that right side, and now I got a chance to get him vertically on the post. That's all I'm trying to show you, okay? So that's kind of the idea here. So again, we can kind of build around this principle, and really, you know, you're not going to particularly be really worried too much about the double Mabel coverage. Most of the time, they're going to ironically leave this post wide open. I'm just telling you from personal experience. However, if they don't, if they go to the post, you do have your running back check down. You can also start playmakering if something goes wrong, something like this. When they start dropping nine people back in a zone drop, you will start to find that you're going to have stuff like that open to the running back. But what I find a lot, just in my experience, you know, kind of running this offense, is if they is that they're going to carry the drag because it's the first route that's going to come into their area. So it's going to look like this, and then the middle of the field is going to be wide open for the post. Okay, so it's really just a simple two-man read between the post and the drag, or the dig and the drag. Okay, very simple concept here. But what I really like about this is why, it's just such a good play for double Mabel coverage. Now, another thing you could do if you wanted a little bit of a quick release route against the blitz is you could put that running back on an out route. Very good route for man-to-man, as you can see. A little bit better than that block and release check down for this kind of concept here. So, again, you could just simply do that. And I just really like how this plays. And really, no matter what the coverage, you can either take your drag, like where I see how they still would get pulled vertically, and now I got my drag for 10 to 15 yards, or if they come down on stuff, now they have to use her, Gronkowski. Now, another thing that you could do if you wanted to, just to give yourself a little bit of a buffer or a little bit of a check down, is you could do it from this side. So you could do something like this right here, where we post Mike Evans as well, so we've got those two runoff deep verticals, but then we have a deep comeback or a deep curl on the outside. And the reason why you would do something like that is because later on in the play, you can the shallow cross concept still the same basic concept, but now what you've got is you've got a little comeback route in your arsenal as well. Because again, when you throw this route, if you actually think about the timing of everything, When you go to throw this, you're throwing the ball right here, which that corner is still technically getting ran off. Now you got a blocker, and you know, to me, that's a little bit better of a way to do this concept. So again, very simple, but don't underestimate how good this comeback is. I'm telling you right now. So let's say, for example, you get shaded down coverage, right? So you get something like this. Now this is where this fade is valuable. If you want to run a fade to the left, you certainly can do that, as long as you have the hot route abilities or whatever. But let's say, you know, you get a cover two. Well, now you can hit this fade on the outside on the wide side, or even if that's a comeback, you still have some opportunity to be able to work that concept as well. So again, I love this play. You don't have to do the adjustments that I'm doing. For example, if I wanted to do it like this, I could just literally just tag a comeback on that side, put an out route out there, and that'll be fine. And if I get a blitz, I'm going to either go to the running back route or I'm going to go to the drag, depending on if their user jumps the running back or does he jump the drag. You know, again, it's a read. But to me, this is a very, very simple concept. One of my favorites, though, to teach, because it's just so simple. And I'm telling you, that route right there is just such a good route to kind of mix in with your drag. And I just love this concept a lot. So anyways, thought I'd share it with you today. If you want to learn more about the air raid, you want to learn more how to run the spread in Madden, or if you want to get some of my trip stuff or my bunch stuff or my defenses, join the Patreon for just $10 a month. You get access to every ebook that I release in Madden 22. So if you want to get access to that, head on down to the description of the video. I put a link down there for you where you can join the Patreon. So just click that link and head over and check out that website.